Good afternoon to everyone. So we are discussing the concept of power factor matrix. So in the previous classes, we took two classes up to now. We discussed about the, from the basic, we discussed about the definition of power factor. We analyzed what is the purpose of power factor matrix, where we can connect the power factor matrix. And next we have seen the classification of power factor matrix. So we have discussed various classifications of power factor matrix, like electrodynamometer type power factor matrix. In electrodynamometer type power factor matrix also, there are two classifications. One is single phase electrodynamometer type power factor meter, and three phase electrodynamometer type power factor meter. And we have seen the torque diagram. We have seen the torque expression, and we analyzed the phasor diagram analysis of three phase power factor type electrodynamometer type wattmeter. So in today's class, we will discuss about moving iron type power factor meter. So what is meant by power factor? Well, most of you are very familiar. Power factor is nothing but cosine of angle between voltage and current. Okay. So where we can use the power factor meters means, power factor meters are utilized at the inception of transmission system in order to categorize what is the behavior of power factor. What is the behavior of power factor, either with respect to the load condition. Either it may be an industrial load or it may be a domestical load, whatever it may be the load scenario. So if we see further into the classification, what we analyzed the classification into various steps, like single phase electrodynamometer type power factor meter, three phase electrodynamometer type power factor meter. So in today's class, we are going to analyze moving iron type power factor meter. In moving iron type power factor meter, MI type. Moving iron type. So we will have two classifications. One is rotating iron magnetic field, and second one is alternating field magnetic field. Two types: rotating iron magnetic field and number of alternating magnetic field. So if we go into the discussion, so moving iron type power factor meter. Moving iron, name in the self represents. We will come across again the concept of soft iron piece here. So the moving iron power factor meter is also categorized into two classifications. One is rotating magnetic field and alternating type magnetic field. So rotating magnetic field, so how can we analyze or how can we categorize this rotating magnetic field power factor meter means, so there is a concept of rotating magnetic field. Most of you people come this concept of rotating magnetic field in your induction motor, in your electrical machines too, at the concept of induction motor, rotating magnetic field. What is the concept of rotating magnetic field? Where we can come, how the rotating magnetic field is created in general electrical machines? One second. So at what particular instant we will come across this type of moving iron type power factor meter? Means this is a peculiar instant. Moving iron type power factor meter, okay, works under the concept of rotating magnetic field. So how does the rotating magnetic field works here? See, what that means, before going into the discussion of rotating magnetic field, how works in a moving iron type power factor meter. Now we are discussing rotating field power factor meter. So how this rotating magnetic field comes means, so whenever a three phase supply, so see this is a three phase meter, okay, moving iron type power factor meter, we are discussing about three phase meters. This is a three phase meter. In this concept of three phase meter, what we are doing, see here, so three phase, whenever the three phase supply is given to the whenever three phase supply is given to this particular field, see A1, A2, A3, So these three particular fields, A1, A2, A3, three phase supply is given to three particular fields, which are displaced at a particular dimension of 120 degrees. The phase angle between A1, A2, A3 is 120 degrees. So whenever three phase supply is given, okay, so this fields A1, A2, A3, these three fields will create a certain amount of magnetic field, at a particular phase displacement of 120 degrees. So if we analyze the construction, rotating field type moving iron power factor meter. So this is the first classification we are discussing about, that is rotating field type power factor meter. So this rotating field type power factor meter will contains three coils. Here we can see the three coils A1, A2, A3, three coils which are supplied with respect to three phase mains. See, electrical energy is supplied with the from current transformers here. Okay, so coil inside, there is a coil P. This coil P is at the center of the coils here. Coil P is placed in between center of the coils, three coils, which is connected in series with respect to a resistance across the lines of the supply. So inside the coil P, we can pivot a rod here. See, here inside the coil P, we can pivot a rod, iron rod. So here we go, after pivoting the iron rod, we can connect the soft iron pieces here. See, two soft iron pieces are connected inside the coil P. Okay, soft iron pieces, this is S1 and this is S2, two soft iron pieces. And for the damping torque is also created with the help of an additional technique. The main purpose of damping torque is to nullify the unwanted deflections. So here there is no consideration of controlling torque. The most of the control is achieved with the help of damping control itself by providing a damping spindle. Okay, so this is about the construction. The construction is simple here in the construction we have three coils, A1, A2 and A3, so which are supplied with respect to three current transformer. Current transformer 3 is connected with respect to A3, current transformer 2 is connected with respect to A2, and current transformer 1 is connected here. So in this manner we connected the supply to the A1, A2, A3, three particular coils. These three particular coils are displaced at a particular dimension of 120 degrees. And next, what we did, we connected the supply. Okay, we connected the three phase supply. So in with respect, what happens after connecting the supply, A1, A2, A3 is energized with respect to the electrical supply, and that creates a rotating magnetic field. Okay, that creates a rotating magnetic field. So at that very particular instant, after the creation of rotating magnetic field, okay, so the coil is placed here, A1, A2, in between A1, A2, A3 fields, we placed the coil and we pivoted the spindle. See, this black spot is nothing but a spindle, and we connected the vanes here on the coil itself. So what will happen? So this is about the construction. So if we observe the working operation, okay, the moving iron will carry the magnetic flux. Okay, the moving iron system, which is A1, A2, A3, will create the magnetic flux. So these vanes will carry the alternating flux that tends to rotate continuously on a particular position. So the position of this particular rotation, depending upon the field produced by A1, A2, A3 coils. Okay, so the position, relative position of the moving vanes is depending upon the flux produced by the coils. So depending upon the moving system, this is approximately equal to the phase angle displacement in between current and voltage of three phase circuit. Okay, so the moving system, or the angular displacement position, or the twisting force, or the torque produced by this particular coil. So this coil is nothing but rotating coil with respect to vanes. So the moving position is produced with respect to the vanes with the help of three coils A1, A2, A3. The help of coils A1, A2, A3. So what we did here, so with the help of a current flowing through A1, A2, A3 coils, we created a rotating magnetic flux. In the presence of that rotating magnetic flux, we placed the moving system. The moving system will about to rotate in the presence of the rotating magnetic field. Okay, so this rotation of these main vanes will depend upon the flux created by the field coils A1, A2, A3. Okay, so the flux produced by the field coils A1, A2, A3 coils will create the flux. Okay, that flux is depend upon the phase angle between voltage and current of three phase system. Okay, so that means here the presence of moving iron instrument, the presence of moving iron instruments will depend upon the behavior of three phase system current. Okay, and that means the presence of iron piece inside the coil P is depend upon the reactance of coil P. See here, and an additionally important thing is resistance also. Okay, so depend upon the current position and voltage position, the flux is created, and in the presence of the flux, the coil will start deflecting. So this is about the peculiar description of a rotating type power factor meter. So what is the construction? A1, A2, A3. Three coils, three field coils are placed at a particular one dimension of 120 degrees, which is displaced from each other. Next, what is the construction? A coil is placed, a moving coil is placed in between the three field coils. Okay, and a vane system is attached with respect to a spindle on the coil. Okay, after the rotating magnetic flux is created with respect to the current injection to the three coils. Okay, what will happen in the presence of the rotating magnetic flux? This vane system, this coil will start rotating. That means the force of this particular rotating coil, depending upon the current injection to these three coils. Okay, and current injection with respect to the coils, depending upon voltage and current relation in this particular three phase system. So that is about rotating field type power factor meter. So coming into the second classification of moving iron type power factor meters, that is alternating field type power factor meter. So this is a different system. Okay, so this shows the alternating field type moving iron power factor meter. See here, this is alternating field type moving iron power factor meter. This is also called as Lippmann power factor meter. Another name is Lippmann power factor meter. So if we analyze the construction here, the construction consisting of three sets of moving iron. So this is the first set B1. So this is the second set B2, and this is the third set B3. Okay, B1 is first set of moving iron, B2 is second set of moving iron, B3 is third set of moving iron, which are mounted on a particular common spindle. See, this is a common spindle. So there is a magnetic separation. Here we placed the non-magnetic materials. In old concept, they used iron. They used a soft wood in order to separate B2 from B1. They used a soft wood. The non-magnetic separation is done between B1, B2, B3, which is displaced at a particular dimension of 120 degrees in a parallel places. Okay, the displacement between B1 and B2, the displacement between B2 and B3, okay, the displacement between three of them, that is around 120 degrees. Okay, so the soft iron piece is placed here. Okay, the damping vanes or the soft iron piece is placed here. Okay, so here we have current coil. See, this is nothing but current coil segmentation. On the particular B1, B2, B3 moving iron sets, we also connected the coil segmentation. C1, C2, C3. That means this coil is represented as a current coil. This coil is represented as current coil, and this coil is represented as pressure coil. the pressure coil is placed on B1, B2, B3, which is represented as C1, C2, and C3. Okay, so the current coil is placed here, and this the current coil is placed here. Current coils, with respect to the current coils, the pressure coil is placed on B1, B2, and B3. With respect to the spindle itself, we connected the damping wings. See, these two are nothing but a perpendicular representation of damping wings, which is connected next to a pointer. See, next we connected a pointer. Okay, next we connected a pointer here. Okay, so that is about the representation of, this is about the construction here. So another most important thing in construction is connecting of resistance with respect to the current coils. So here we connected the resistance here. Connected resistance with respect to the coil C3. There is a resistance connected with respect to coil C2. There is a resistance connected with respect to the coil C1. Okay, the main purpose of connecting these resistances, because what is the main purpose of connecting these resistances? In order to reduce the current from these pressure coils. Okay, so the current coil A and A, these current coils are split into two halves. Okay, one is on the first side of the moving system, and one is on the second side of pressure coil system. Okay, so the spindle of the moving system is connected with respect to the damping vanes, and it is also connected with respect to the pointer here. So if we analyze the working structure, when the instrument is connected across the supply, the power factor is to be measured. The moving system in the instrument turns into a certain position, that the actual torque of this particular moving iron pieces is equal to the magnitude and opposite in direction to the reluctant torque. That means the reluctant torque of a total moving system is said to be zero. That means what is the conception here? At a steady state position, that means if we read the actual power factor of a line, at that particular steady state position of moving system, okay, the deflection of the iron piece is magnetized by some of the current coils that is equal to the phase angle of the voltage. That means if the current is in phase with respect to the voltage, okay, the current flowing in the current coils is in phase with respect to the voltage flowing in the pressure coils at that instant, okay, at that instant an exact reading is provided with the help of a pointer. Is provided with respect to the pointer. So as the three phase coils are of different levels, no resultant rotating magnetic field is produced here. But how can we analyze the thing? Means here the three phase balanced system, it is suitably modified with the help of a two phase, or it can be also modified with respect to a single phase system. That means what actually happened means here in the system here, in the working analysis, the current is flown with respect to the current coil. One part of the current coil is placed next to the pointer, next to the moving system, and another part of the current coil is connected next to the potential coil or voltage element. Okay, the current coils is called as current element, we know the nomenclature, and the potential coils or pressure coils or moving coils is known as voltage elements. Okay, so whenever the current flowing in the current coil is in phase with respect to the voltage in the potential coil, at that instant the needle will reach to a steady state position. What is steady state position? Steady state position is nothing but the certain amount of power factor flowing in the particular transmission line. Okay, so this is about Lippmann alternating field type moving iron power factor meter. So there are various advantages here. What are the major advantages? Means the scale is extended up to 360 degrees. We can see a complete scale. Okay, and the instrument is quite simple and robust. There is no severe losses here. It is comparatively cheap, and most important thing is this type of dynamometer type power factor meter is mostly used in large working forces at heavy burden loads. Okay, and what is the major drawback or major disadvantages? Means With respect to the variation of supply frequency, the voltage and waveforms are to be calibrated properly, and there is an accuracy in the dynamometer type power factor meter. There is a problem with accuracy. With respect to the errors which is present in the iron pots, there is a problem of accuracy in this particular moving iron type power factor meter. So if we observe the overall advantages and overall disadvantages here, the accuracy is one of the prime concern. The accuracy is one of the prime concern with this meter. Okay, this is one of the prime concern in this meter. So in today's class, we discussed about moving iron type power factor meter, and also we discussed about alternating field type power factor meter. So up to now, we analyzed about the purpose of power factor meter. We have seen various classifications of power factor meters: single phase electrodynamometer type power factor meter. Okay, and next we discussed about the torque expression, actual torque expression of single phase electrodynamometer type power factor meter. We have seen three phase, and we analyzed the three phase electrodynamometer type power factor meter with the help of a phasor diagram, and we derived the torque expression for this. And next we discussed about rotating field type power factor meter, and next we analyzed alternating field type moving iron power factor meter, and we have seen the advantages and disadvantages at this point of discussion. What is the difference between rotating field type and alternating field type? So one of the peculiar differences is construction. So if we compare the thing here, if we compare rotating field type moving iron type power factor meter with alternating field type power factor meter, see here, if we see the coil distribution, see the coil distribution is 120 degrees apart. So here the current coil is represented in two equal halves. So there are various quite constructional differences. The major difference is the operation of rotating magnetic field. The rotating magnetic field is created with the help of coil segmentation. Indukani ikkada rotating magnetic field ostundi ante, because three coils A1, A2, A3, which are displaced 120 degrees apart, this, which is not practically observed with respect to moving iron alternating field type power factor meter. Okay, the coil distribution is quite different. That makes the creation of rotating magnetic field in this type of power factor meter than this. And an additional important thing is here, the scale is uniform. In a rotating field type power factor meter, the scale is uniform, but here the scale is in a direction of 360 degrees. Okay, so that is about the actual differences. Okay, I think it's clear.